Australian Model Rail Association, West Australian Division, in August 2021, main clubroom entrance. The event of today is a mini model train exhibition, and there's a WA model car club, or light car club of WA. There are exhibits in that second hall as well. Let's have a look. We've got a couple of exhibits on display, so let's have a wander in. Very happy A.M.R.A. member here. Hello to everyone.
What are you doing, Kevin?
Another gorgeous person from A.M.R.A.
Hey.
Good morning.
Another wonderful person here at A.M.R.A. See, happy people.
Yes. Where's this going to be published?
On YouTube. Hey, John. Well, let's go have a proper look. Now, Holt Whistle has been around for a number of years. This is its present form in 2021. The idea mirrors on the back wall, so those operating in the front can see the sightings out the back.
You might have things to do with that.
Yeah.
Did you want to have another drive?
Yes, please.
Okay, so you turn this little arrow to me. Towards me. Yep, more.
There you go.
Alright, we're going to go drive into the tunnel. Turn this one this way. Keep going.
Get more. Here you go.
Aeroplanes got to be back. Everybody's got one.
You're in control, mate.
Easy to control. Wow,
one of many new drive layouts that are here.
Turn it back this way when it comes
around. Simple HO00 scale layout.
Stop. Okay, you're in control. Turn it this way. That way. Okay. Big crowd, mate. Yeah, that's it.
Just gotta get out of the way.
it's like if you go around this lap, you'll see you'll see the old stuff they used to use. And what happens is after a while, because it's raw, it dries out. This one goes quite out. This is the stuff that goes wooden seams supply all. But like this, this grass is pretty flat. You can get 5 millimeter grass later on static, so literally get. If you go on, you've got YouTube?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Go on YouTube.
Yeah. If you see
A.M.R.A is really good. Also,
he's going to bring it to a halt.
Push it back a bit.
Just give it. Did you want me to push it?
Yeah, just push it back a bit. There we go.
Select logo.
Did you cancel that out?
No, leave.
Enter. Oh, not up to flat
out. 128 flat
out. What question was that?
I just checked 20 points.
This is a scale model of Swan View. The sun might be hard to read the light reflection. This is on the original main eastern line from Perth to Kalgoorlie. That's prior to the standardisation. This is a model in SM3.5.
They were just ordinary. Now they're smart ATMs, you know, they can take money and change and all that. Anyway, I went in the other day and there was one teller and one woman trying to sell a line to somebody. That's all that's left of my branch, two people. There used to be about six in them.
This in 2021 is this platform and a roof. All the rest of the buildings no longer exist at this stage until such time somebody decides to go ahead and make a brand new version of them.
Bridge is filled in now.
These two X classes are coming from Perth.
Someone do a circle on them.
And several steam cars heading towards Perth from Kalgoorlie.
They combine them into sort of central important areas.
There's also
Morrison Road Bridge, which is in the background. You wouldn't even know it was a bridge, but Morrison Road still exists.
They work for the banks, and they get a commission.
Yes, they also work for some of the loan sharks.
They also work for them. They also work for themselves.
Nice hat.
Very cool. Yeah. That was my
can I get attention, please? Vehicle up to vehicle, it's a Toyota CS7. the number plate starts with 1GNL. Needs to be removed from the gates, please. Over the other side.
Subject of SN 3.5 and local West Australian South, here's Skilford Station, Perth Midland Line. Train back out from Midland. Your DD with some ACL carriages. At the moment this is just point to point, but I'm led to believe it'll be a complete circuit.
I've got a fair bit of American brass here. I like to use a show shack. it was the prototype when I did it, and the S15 hadn't been released.
Ah, right. Was the wheel base correct on the S15?
It's very close.
So there was a bit of a gap between the rear driver.
Yes.
If you don't extend the Mahano, it was...
As we go from the front room into the second hall, no gauge layout, sign of construction, some LGB, in the background some O gauge, and come up to HO. Some of the modelling that's been done. The level of detail you can go to in O-gauge and G-scale is ridiculously good. A lot will depend on your skills. Or that's still a devil you know. One of Amra's O gauge layouts. We have a feature center quarry foot gauge railway. You can see the comparison here in the shot. In the center gauge and the center foot gauge. This is the 7 foot quarter inch locomotive. 222. Very well scratch built and detailed. Along with its carriages. Thank you.
Please answer questions.
This will give you some of the idea, or an idea of some of the detail that's been done. The detail on this bridge alone would have taken ages. And underneath, you'd probably miss out on some of the under details. That's the level of detail you can do in O gauge. Pascal German layout. Back here. Again, the mirrors. So you can see opposite side of the layout. The American layout called Valentine Run. Extension on the layout. Thank you. Printed by a friend of mine called John, and on display here.
Too bloody small, mate. Yes, I reckon it's too bloody small.
You would.
I would, yeah.
That's why we're put on glasses nowadays.
Nice.
I might meant to be a statue here, so I'll accept it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But when someone like Terry Hammond puts it in a lake and on a southern lake, I'm out of it.
Here's the back of the Western Ridge layout. The Austrian set coming through with the next class in the front. This one's fitted with DCC sound.
Valentine, you've got RF from, I think, the large scale.
Swan View.
We can move up to 5 here.
We've got 5 on this one.
But that still won't affect you.
No.
Won't affect you?
No, we need the 5G.
Not at all.
Stand in front of a radar, that might fit.
There's another one with John. That's one of his P classes. APR.
It's on that race train.
Some of what you've just been seeing from the W.A.G.R. side of things. This is how you get in contact with me, mate John. This is some of his 3D prints. That's a lot of 3D printing these days. And just to prove his 3D printing, you can 3D print in Z scale. Because this is all M. If you go to the Kev's Workshop website and go to the links page, right near the top is a link to John's website. And off that, you'll be able to order some W.A.G.R. Leading from this part of the hall, came outside the live steam. Hey Mick.
How are you?
Not too bad, mate. Good to see you rock up.
Yeah. Put the grandkids down.
Cool.
You don't know where to look.
I'm heading back over to my display at the moment. I've got to get video of this. Give you an idea on G scale. This is a live steam, New South Wales C38, number 3801, 5 litre. And we've got the Newcastle Fire carriages behind it.
That's probably
staging yards at the end here. Newcastle fire sort of carriages in the back. You can see a bit of few details.
What is? Oh, yes.
That's the oval part of the main line.
They're going in to have a rest, and they keep breaking with the body transfer.
Transfer from the main club rooms. They're on. Getting through to the light car club of WA. This is where the rest of the exhibits are. Model of a drive-in. There is video up on YouTube already of this. This is a new scale. Cars down here, fitted with fiber optics, head and tail lights. Just to show you what we've done. In a nighttime setting, this looks even better still, of course. Can see here what I've put into it. So we see it on the fence. The ladder's missing. I don't know where that's gone. It was there earlier. The gate's actually open and closed as well. Most of the videos that I've seen on my drive-in are actually downloaded from YouTube. Thanks to all those people who have uploaded this stuff. And for those who don't know or haven't seen before, I drilled all these holes for the stars. In behind it is some LED lighting. Up here, not far above the screen. Southern Cross, come through the night sky, there's two false Southern Crosses that you'll see, that's one of them. Up here's the other one, and as we get higher and higher where the aeroplane is, if the camera will focus on it, it possibly won't. It's having a bit of a problem. Up here somewhere you can see the saucepan. There you go. That's all the stars in my night sky. Hard to see inside. There's a ticket collector, sales, whatever. what I'll do while it's on display. I'll probably go around and take a video. It's all the videos that you'll be watching today. If you just stay here and watch it from beginning to end. So each playlist has an arrangement and length of play. So each playlist goes for roughly about an hour. It's all themed for the era and on display. This is the Blacktown driving west of Sydney, where I spend a lot of my time on stage. And Australian Model Railway magazine, which featured my driving. Photos in this article were supplied by me as well. By my son Thomas, new HO, 4 foot by 4 foot. Oh, 1.2 metres by 1.2 metres. Doing white locomotive. I remember playing that when I was about 6 or 7 years old. The runs up all these years. Fortunately, the smoke keeps getting low in the wrong way. But as you can see it from my point of view, after rebuilding the locomotive and putting the dock figure onto the side of it, I've actually put real wood in the tender as per the movie. Should be sitting around there, but as you see, wind blows it. It was much tighter. There's my DeLorean. Made all circuits for that. Done the wheels as well. There is a previous video up on YouTube of this running. And the scene that I tried modelling, it's that scene from the movie. I just a sec. Simple end scale view drive. Model Railways, you buy off the internet as well. And it's Peter, the guy who owns the place. Over here, Burfoot Tools. If you want to buy some really good tools for doing modelling with, this is the sort of arrangement they have. Murray's a guy that owns a business. They tend to have really good tools. Stuff that I use. Worth looking up Burfoot Tools. Also in my website and my links page. There you go, Murray.
Going fantastic.
Good. Scale. This is all part of what you can do with railway modelling.
Okay. Thank you.
outside of the Model Railway Club and the car club, there's an outdoor radio controlled car track. It's hard to keep up with them. Carnage everywhere. Bit hard to keep up with. As you see, these cars wind out a fair bit. The off-roaders, the drivers, gives you the track up there.